Okay, everybody, we're going to do a quick overview about how to do a search on multifamilies and set it up for a client. I'm not going to do something specific. I'm just going to give you kind of all the options. First thing you're going to do is come to search, go to multifamily and detail. Then you're going to get all of these fields to with which you can make your search. So, I like to do active and coming soon, although multifamilies don't do a lot of coming soon. Make sure you have sale, unless you want auctions or something. The most general are that we pick St. Louis, depending on what you want here. So this is the county, St. Louis and St. Louis City. I pick Missouri. now everything else from here is going to depend on your client. So depending on the size of the building and how much you want to refine your search, you can pick either up to 4 units or 5 units and more. The other thing that I like to do is in type of unit, and your layout may not be exactly the same as mine because I've added some fields. I'll show you how to do that. But if, for example, Julia had asked me a question, he wants to look at 2 families only. Then I would choose 2 families. I usually tend to keep them open, maybe only to, in this case, 2 to 4, because unless there's a very specific reason why somebody doesn't want more than 2 units, you might find a 3 or a 4 unit that would work for somebody. So we go on down here. You can do any of these that you might want. What I would say is, specifically with school district, doesn't work super great, but you could do it. If it's a lot of school districts or even any of these, for example, if somebody wants a certain municipality or a township, this is pretty specific to St. Louis County. Whereas if you want to control by neighborhood in the city, that's a different field. You have to add it. So you can add fields here. That's the neighborhood field. And so those St. Louis City neighborhoods, which are not municipalities, all of St. Louis City is one municipality, you can find them here. If you're ever combining both, where you want some counties or some municipalities in the city or in the county and some in the city, my best advice is to do a not, which means you don't want to see these, the ones that you select. Why is that? Because when you do the opposite, if you select only specific neighborhoods and then you select only specific municipalities, then it's only going to show the things that meet all of your criteria. So excluding the ones that you do not want to see is more effective, where if you pick the ones you do want to see and you cross 2 fields like that, they will basically, you'll turn up with nothing in your search because nothing will meet both of those criteria, right? So let's say for the sake of this, these are here. These are the number of beds per unit and the number of full baths per unit. I find like this is not consistently filled out. So you can, if using it, you can possibly eliminate quite a bit of listing. So for the most part, when you only want something like, say, 2 bedroom units, you almost have to eyeball it because the data is not consistent enough to turn up everything that exists. Some people, some agents do not fill out the number of bedrooms per unit. And so without that, those fields or these, which are the number of 3 bedroom units, 2 bedroom units, or 1 bedroom units, these also don't tend to work well. And then this one I think does work pretty well. So if you wanted to see like 10 units or above, you could use that. If you wanted to control by the selling terms, meaning will they take an FHA or VA, you could do this, but it is possible that like you could pick like FHA here. It's possible that some people didn't fill them out, or some people that will accept FHA did not select this when they did their listing. And so it's also kind of a confusion between selling terms versus financing, right? So those could be mutually exclusive if you choose from both of them. And I honestly, I do not know why. I'd love to see Maris come through and make this have regulations so that there's quality data in there. But the data put in is not quality, and then confusing fields like these are also not helpful in refining that way. So if you see here, there's really not even an explanation of what's supposed to be in these fields. So that's the tricky part. So if you get what you want selected, and that, for me, it just depends. You could also, instead of using neighborhoods, you could go to the map right there. And so you can see everything right now. You can do a variety of things if you just want to draw areas. So you can do a radius, a rectangle. Most commonly, I do this polygon, because with that, let's see, if I come here, I could literally draw whatever I wanted. So if I only wanted things, you know, within a certain amount of distance from Forest Park, I could do that. And then you can exclude or delete that shape. So that's how you would do that. I'm just going to delete it for now. Delete the shape. And then you'll go to your results to see what your results are. Now from here, let's say this was the search that you wanted. If you want a very generic search, this comes out automatically. What you need to do is you can just save, and you can do a new auto email. If you just want to save the search criteria so you can come open it up anytime, then you do a new saved search. When somebody is super new to me and I want to see what they're going to get before they look at it, because like I said, sometimes you have to eyeball to see how many bedrooms or whatever. I'm just going to select myself right here. You can add a new contact and then they'll be here. And you put your subject. I like to make it depending on the, you can see I use St. Louis and multifamily a lot in my name, because a lot of my clients are from out of town. So whatever is appropriate to who you are sending property to, my suggestion would be to use as much descriptors as possible to acknowledge that they may be talking to other agents. They may be looking in other cities. And so the subject should be descriptive to them, not to you, right? So you do that. This is going to be your welcome email. This is going to be your recurring email. When you set up a contact, you can set up the salutation and a forewarning. It comes as, "Hi, Lynn Hart." So it comes with this, right? Dear this. So you can enter a custom one. You can choose between hi or hello, right? Just so you don't sound like a whatever, right? Make sure that you have your profile set up so that you have a signature and a photo and a banner on things. You can also change what you want to say in the recurring email. I don't put anything, but I guess I don't have it as a default, but you can put, you can put whatever you'd like there, right? So this shows the criteria. These are your settings. I like to deselect show this contact in reverse prospecting. What that means is if I have a listing, I can go see all the agents with people who are hitting my listing on a search, and then I can choose to email all of those agents. And for me, it's annoying. I don't really want, an agent will come in and they'll basically blast everybody because you've got somebody on a search. Well, you already saw that property. Your client probably already saw that property. We don't need an agent to come put it in front of you again. But in certain circumstances, it might make sense. Not everybody does that. You can also mark if you want this as a favorite search. You can only have 10. And then you can decide if they were to come immediately or daily, and even on certain days of the week. Monthly, I don't think is very helpful in our market. Okay, so I would normally, when I'm going to handpick, choose concierge, but since I'm sending it to myself, let me give you an example of what that would be like. Basically, if I were to, I want to pick somebody that, I just don't want to send something somebody accidentally. So I can now enable concierge search, which means you can get notifications by email. You're going to get notifications as well. and then you will go in, pick them, and release them, right? And that way, everything that's on the search wouldn't show up right now, only the things that you approve. So if you have this selected and you pick save, go to approvals, then here's, this is going to go, right? And you would save, go to approvals. Oh, I have to put a subject line. So let's see now. So basically what you would do is you could go through, you'll have to touch every one of these, but you could go, oh, 4243 botanical. Let's see. That has 2-bedroom units. If that's what he wanted. So you could either approve it one at a time. No, no, you can't one at a time. You can approve all of them, but you just check mark it, right? Move on to the next ones. Go through whatever you need to do. Maybe you don't want this one. So now that you've got one selected, notice you can reject or approve. You got to do one thing at a time. So let's say this one's not going to work and this one is. Then I could go down and that's all I want. When I click approve, everyone I selected is going to go send out to that client. Or if I don't like them, I can reject them. And then it will reject those two listings. But you're still left with 184 things to review. It's always worse the first time. And then after that, it will show up here. And this is only if you're doing concierge search. If you chose an automated search, then it's just going to go automatically. So here's Jose. You can see in my concierge box. And if I click him, then these are all the things I need to approve. So you can do it later. But once you get it done, it's kind of more like this. I haven't done approvals in a couple of days, but you can see this is a particular client. I know they're not going to come up into this price range. Maybe here. So maybe I'll approve that one. And this one, they're not going to go up really past maybe fours or threes, but I think they want a little work to do. Let's look at those. I'm just going to go with that. So I'll approve those for them. And then they show me the remaining ones. And what I'll do is, well, I want to, before I reject, I want to approve some of these. Some more. So let's approve those to go through. Normally on these, I would have reviewed the financials, but I kind of know some of those properties. So that's why I just went ahead and approved them. So you could click right here and do reject, and then you're clean. And then as new property comes up, it'll show up here, but you're not going to, this is a separate search for Uthra. You're not going to, if I only had one search for her, you wouldn't have seen that there. So here, we can release some of these. Approve them. Okay. So I'm going to reduce it. So if I have rejected everything that's for her, you won't see her over in the concierge anymore. And if you had selected something as a favorite search, then you would find it here, right? These are my favorite searches. So it's just a placeholder. So I could go in and see what's on multifamily under 800 in the area and the criteria that I had picked. So I hope this is helpful for you. I will send it out as soon as it uploads. Oh no. Such a pain in the ass.